So, hello everybody. I'd like to welcome you in my today's seminar. We have once more scientific presentations in biology. I say welcome to my students here in the room, and of course I welcome my online audience. So for today, we are working with a very interesting topic in biology. This is, now you see this on top there, behavior. Behavior is a fascinating field of research, and when talking in terms of behavior, of course we need vocabulary. So for today, I was just selecting some words that are very, very important in the field of research of behavior, and I would like to understand a little more what do these words mean. So at first, I will read the words aloud, both in English and the translation in German, and then we think a little bit on that. So let me start with the first very important word, adaptive. Adaptive, sich anpassend, is a key word in behavior. Many research in our behavior is just done with animals, so Tieren. So whereas the research with plants is not too just important, unfortunately, but maybe this will develop. We have annual, jährlich, einjährig. Attention, die Aufmerksamkeit, wird auf etwas gelenkt. Avoid, vermeiden. The behavior, of course, das Verhalten, we were talking so much on that already. And we have a very important word, circadian, circadian, tagesperiodisch. So, this is very interesting to understand the circadian behavior of some organisms. And in order to explain a little bit more, I was selecting a very interesting example that I like very much, because this is actually touching my research. So, you see this there on top on the right hand. So this is a very, very interesting plant. This is the Mesembryanthemum crystallinum. This is the commonized plant. So this is a plant that comes from Southern Africa. It's germinating here during the rainy season, and it's later on adapting to dry environments. And here there comes the fact that we have a circadian rhythm in this plant. So what these plants are doing? So they have the so-called crystalline acid metabolism, the CAM metabolism. What does this mean? These plants close the stomata at day. In the night, they open them, they fix CO2, they produce malate. And the malate is during the day then used once more to generate CO2. And the CO2, the carbon dioxide, is just used for the generation of carbohydrates. So this is a typical example and a very nice example for circadian rhythm. So let us focus once more on words in behavior. So the next word, this is circadian, Jahresperiodisch. This is just different from circadian. We have cognition, Erkennung, Wahrnehmung, conditioning. We have developmental, Entwicklung. This might just touch the development as well. And we have the diversity, die Vielfalt, Diversität, as a very interesting word. So let me focus once more back to the word of circadian. This is a very interesting word, and we can just think on plants once more. So if you have a look there, you see a typical and very nice example from circadian. This is a brilliant change of color of leaves in autumn. So we find this in the northern hemisphere. So here we have the situation that plants are in winter, they don't have any leaves, they get tiny leaves in spring, they develop, they are green, they do the photosynthesis, and in autumn, so the days are shorter, the temperatures are decreasing, and this is just a signal for the plants to change the color, the chlorophyll is degraded, and they produce the carotene is more obvious, and they get this very, very marvelous color that we can just see over there. So this is a typical, very nice example for circadian rhythms. So with that, I think I was just giving you a very nice and brief introduction into behavior, and I think with that we would like to stop for today with that, and I'm looking forward to the next seminar where we will work once more with behavioral vocabulary. So at the moment I say thank you very, very much for your attention, and see you next time here in the seminar. Thanks a lot.